Hello students, in continuity of chapter 6, today we are going to study about vascular tissue system and anatomy of dicot and monocot plants. First of all, we are starting with vascular tissue system. If we talk about composition of vascular tissue system in plants, it is actually made up of complex tissues. Complex tissue means, as you know very well, it is like phloem and xylem. And xylem and phloem together, they constitute vascular bundle in plants. In dicot stem, cambium is present, but in monocot stem, it is absent. So, on the basis of this absence and presence of cambium, vascular bundles are classified into two types. They may be open or closed type of vascular bundle. First, open type of vascular bundle. This type of vascular bundle, they are having cambium in between xylem and phloem, and generally it is observed in dicotyledon stem. Here in figure also you can see the arrangement of open kind of vascular bundle. Here cambium is present in between phloem and xylem, which are both are complex tissues, vascular tissue, and due to this activity of cambium, it means that it's a secondary meristematic tissue and it is having property of continuous cell division, and that's why such a type of vascular bundle is known as open vascular bundle. So this is special feature of vascular bundle, that here cambium, secondary meristematic tissue, is present in between phloem and xylem. If you talk about closed type of vascular bundle, here no secondary meristematic tissue like cambium is present in between phloem and xylem. Generally this type of vascular bundles, they are observed in monocotyledon stem. In this figure you can see this, between phloem and xylem there is no cambium arrangement is there, and this way in vascular bundle arrangement only phloem and xylem is present. If we compare with open type of vascular bundle, here in open type in between phloem and xylem cambium is there, but in closed type of vascular bundle in between phloem and xylem no meristematic tissue like cambium is present. Radial type of arrangement of vascular bundle. In this type of vascular bundle arrangement, xylem and phloem within a vascular bundle are arranged in alternate manner on different radii. Generally it is observed in roots. So this type of arrangement of vascular bundle, it is different kind of vascular bundle than previous type of vascular bundle. Here you can see in figure also, this vascular bundle arrangement, the xylem and phloem, both type of this tissue, conductive tissue, they are on radius alternately arranged. It means that on one radius xylem is there, next is having phloem, again next is having xylem, phloem, this way alternately arranged on different radii, and this type of arrangement is known as radial type of vascular bundle. Another type of vascular bundle, that is conjoint type of vascular bundle. In this type of vascular bundle, the xylem and phloem, they are jointly situated along the same radius of vascular bundle, and such vascular bundles are common. They are common in stem and leaves. So this way conjoint type of vascular bundle arrangement is different than radial type. In radial type vascular bundles, they are arranged on alternate radii, but in conjoint type of vascular bundle, xylem and phloem, they are situated at the same radius, and this observed in stem and leaves. So this way in plants, in different organ like stem, root and leaf, this type of arrangement of tissues, complex tissue, which are conducting tissue like xylem and phloem, and their arrangement, It is known as vascular tissue system, and its main function is to conduct water, mineral, and prepared food. Now let's study anatomy of dicotyledonous root. If you want to study this type of plant organ, any plant organ, that is root, stem or leaf, we can take section, and by taking section we can easily study the internal arrangement, it means that anatomy of this organ. In dicotyledonous root, okay, arrangement of different tissues, it is arranged in different layer. As you know, outermost layer is known as epidermis, and its anatomy of root, that's why it contains root hairs. It means outgrowth of epidermis layer, and these root hairs are unicellular. The function of this root hair, it increase the absorptive area of surface. That is the importance of root hair here. After epidermis tissue tear, outermost is epiblema. Generally here it is known as epiblema in dicotyledon root. The cortex consists of several layer of thin walled parenchymatous cell. It means that just below epidermis, the second layer, the tissue type, is cortex, and it is made up of parenchymatous cell. After cortex, it means innermost layer arrangement, that is endodermis. In endodermis layer, it is having single layer of barrel shaped cell without any intercellular spaces, and radial walls, they are actually having endodermal cells and deposition of this kind of waxy material, suberin, and it is known as Casparian strip. The main feature of this Casparian strip is that it is impermeable to water. So when water or dissolved mineral move further from this layer, actually it is forcibly pushed and move up to next layer. So this way, in dicotyledonous root, first outermost layer, that is epiblema or epidermis, the next one is cortex, and the innermost is endodermis is arranged. This figure, it gives clear idea about anatomy of dicot root. Here you can see the outermost layer, that is epiblema, reserving parenchymatous cell, and outgrowth as a root hair. Here root hairs, they are unicellular in their structure, and their main function is to increase absorptive area of same surface. The following region or layer, it is consist of several layer of thin walled parenchymatous cell, and it is known as cortex. So after epiblema, the next layer is cortex from outside to inside. Immediate after cortex, endodermis layer is there, that is innermost layer. As we talk earlier, here Casparian strip is arranged. It means that cells here, they are thickened by suberin material. Next layer to epidermis layer is endodermis layer, that is pericycle. So after endodermis, next to endodermis, pericycle, this layer is arranged. Then conjunctive tissue, the innermost is pit, is made up of parenchymatous cell, and after pericycle, next to pericycle, arrangement of vascular tissue system, it means that xylem and phloem is there. In between xylem and phloem cells, the xylem and phloem cells in between conjunctive tissue is there. Generally here two or four, it means two to four xylem and phloem pages are there. After that, cambium ring develops between the xylem and phloem. All tissue inner side to the endodermis, such as pericycle, vascular bundle and pith, they collectively known as stele. So by taking TS, transverse section of dicot root. Here we can study the anatomy or arrangement of different layers like epidermis or epiblema, cortex region, endodermis, pericycle, vascular bundle and pith. Easily we can study. Monocotyledonous root and its anatomy. Monocotyledon root anatomy is different than dicot root anatomy. Some similarities are there, but arrangement of vascular bundle is different. Anatomy of the monocot root is similar to in some feature with dicot root. Here, epidermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle, and vascular bundle and pith arrangement is a layer wise arrangement is similar to dicot root. But here, compared to the dicot root, which is having fewer xylem bundles, more than 6 xylem bundles, it means that here polyarch type of arrangement is there. That is a difference between dicotyledon root and monocotyledonous root here. In monocot root, generally more xylem bundles are arranged and there are more than 6 bundles, and for this purpose the term is used, they are actually polyarch in nature. So this way in monocot root also, if we take TS, transverse section, then we can easily study its internal structure or anatomy. In this figure, we can study one by one layer, its arrangement in monocot root. This diagram actually it's a TS, transverse section of monocot root. Here we can see the outermost layer, that is epiblema. Here outgrowth is root hair. It is made up of single layer. Then just below it, next layer, it is cortex. It is made up of few layers of parenchymal tissue. Intercellular spaces are there. Next to cortex, there is endodermis. It is considered as a innermost layer. Centrally located pith is there. Here, then adapter endodermis, vascular bundle arrangement is there, which is clearly observed that polyarch type of arrangement. Here, xylem and phloem, they are arranged alternately. So, on different radius, on different radii, the arrangement of this vascular tissue, it means xylem and phloem is there. And generally, it is in monocot root more than 6, that's why this type of arrangement is known as polyarch. So this way, by taking TS of monocot root, we can study its anatomy and we can clearly study the layers like epiblema, cortex, endodermis and vascular bundles. Dicotyledon stem, its anatomy also we can study. By taking TS or transverse section, again we can easily study internal arrangement of tissues or layers in dicotyledon stem. Here one by one layers are arranged. They are generally epidermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle and vascular bundles. Outermost layer is epidermis here. When we take TS of this type of stem, young stem of this, we can easily study the outermost layer epidermis, which is also a protective layer. Here it is covered with thin layer of cuticle and it may have trichomes or outgrowth and stomata also. After it, cortex arrangement is there. Cortex is made up of not single layer, but generally here in dicot stem, it is made up of multiple layers. It is like hypodermis, then middle one layer parenchymatous cell and innermost cell arrangement, that is endodermis arrangement. Endodermis is innermost layer. cells of endodermis. They are rich in starch grains, and generally it is known as starch sheath. Starch sheath, that is a special feature of dicotyledon stem. Next layer is pericycle, which is next to endodermis. Layers of radially placed parenchyma between the vascular bundle, they are generally known as medullary rays. So this way medullary ray arrangement is observed in between this type of vascular bundle. If we talk about here arrangement of vascular bundles, it means that arrangement of xylem and phloem type of conducting tissue, they are having large number of vascular bundle and they are arranged in a ring, and that type is conjoint and open. Conjoint and open type of vascular bundle, open means they possess cambium in between xylem and phloem. The cambium is present, and that's why the type is open type of vascular bundle. It means that cambium continuously having cell division capacity and girth of stem increase due to its activity. A large number of rounded parenchymatous cell with large intular spaces is present, which occupy central space here, and it constitute pith in this stem. So this way epidermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle and vascular bundles are arranged in dicotyledon stem. This figure is TS or transverse section of dicot stem. One by one arrangement from outer side to inner side, layer wise arrangement of tissues is observed. Outermost is epidermis. Here epidermal hair or its outgrowth is observed, and it is also known as trichome here. Then few layers of tissue is there. It's like a cortex arrangement. Here tissues are like collenchyma, parenchyma. So arrangement of cortex layer is there. Innermost layer, that is endodermis layer. Endodermis is innermost layer, and after it pericycle arrangement is there. After layer of pericycle, the vascular bundle arrangement is clearly observed here, that is made up of phloem, xylem, and in between phloem and xylem, secondary meristematic tissue, that is cambium, is present. Here cambium is having capacity of continuous cell division, and that's why on both side of cambium new cells, it means xylem and phloem, it give rise continuous new cells of xylem and phloem, and that's why the girth of dicot stem increases. So that is main reason behind this, that is generally in dicot stem its girth is more than monocot stem, because they possess open kind of vascular bundle. It means that cambium is present and continuous cell division, it gives rise new layer. Innermost centrally located pith is there. It occupy the central most position, and it is made up of parenchymatous cell, and they are having intercellular spaces. So from outside to inside, when we study the TS, transverse section of this dicot stem, we can easily study layers like epidermis, cortex, endodermis, vascular bundle or vascular tissue system, and pith layer. Monocotyledon stem, its internal structure. In monocotyledon stem also, by taking TS, transverse section, we can study easily one by one layer. These are epidermis, hypodermis, vascular bundle and ground tissue system. Here hypodermis is made up of sclerenchymatous cell. Vascular bundle type is conjoint, close and scattered. It means that comparatively, compared to dicotyledon stem, here cambium is absent, and that's why intergirth, that monocot stem girth, does not increases like a dicot stem, and that's why it's due to this absence of tissue they are having less girth. Each vascular bundle is surrounded in monocotyledonous stem, that is the arrangement sclerenchymatous bundle sheath. Here phloem parenchyma is absent, but special feature of this monocotyledonous stem, its anatomy, they contain water containing cavities. This cavity is present within the vascular bundle that was not observed in dicot stem. Here peripheral vascular bundles, they are generally smaller than centrally located vascular bundle. So this way, in monocotyledonous stem we can study epidermis, hypodermis and vascular bundle system by studying its anatomy. Figure of monocotyledonous stem is transverse section or anatomy or internal structure. By taking TS of this stem, we can study one by one layer arrangement. Left hand side figure, it gives overview of this TS section. Here also we can study the epidermis, hypodermis, vascular bundle and ground tissue is clearly differentiated. Right hand side figure, it gives clear anatomical idea about monocot stem. Here in this figure we can study outermost layer is a single layer arrangement and it is known as epidermis. Just below epidermis, layer of hypodermis is there. Here it is made up of sclerenchymatous tissue, no intercellular spaces are observed. Then the arrangement of vascular bundle is there. Here vascular bundles, they are randomly arranged. Here in vascular bundle arrangement, xylem and phloem, both tissue are present, but cambium, it means secondary meristemic tissue, is absent here, which was present in dicot stem. And all over surrounded tissue, this tissue are ground tissue system. So here by taking TS of monocot stem, we can easily study the layer wise arrangement, that is epidermis, hypodermis, vascular tissue system and ground tissue system. Grasses and all type of grains, it means wheat, rice, maize and other type of cereals, this type of grains, they are considered as a monocot plant. And by taking of TS of this type of stem, any of this stem, we can study typical structure of monocot stem.